We congratulate you once again for your success. And how are you Thanks. Feeling for these results?
Feeling very happy. I mean, I have been working for this, working to get a rank. So finally having achieved this, I think it's a very great feeling.
Okay. So let us first start with the prelims. Prelims is a major obstacle for many people. Even we see several rankers who get a good rank in civil services, but they again fail in the prelims examination. So also they say that prelims has become more dicey. Even if prepare very well, you can just know some 30 to 35 questions perfectly. Remaining, you have to guess in order to clear the examination. So in this context, what do you think the common strategy that you need to follow, or common tips that you suggest the aspirants to clear this examination, the prelims examination?
Yes, even I have gone through that struggle. For the first three attempts, I haven't cleared my prelims. So this was my fourth attempt, and I have cleared all the stages and got this rank. So prelims was very tough for me as well. So I would like to talk about what I have done. I have been doing in the first three attempts, and what differently I did this time. So for the first three attempts, I was excessively relying on knowledge itself to clear the exam, clear the prelim stage. I haven't focused more on solving questions or the previous year questions. So this year, first thing, I mean, there are three or four points that I have done differently. So first, I have kept my sources limited. Whatever books I have been reading, I have kept them limited and revised them multiple number of times. So that has given me that conceptual clarity and also helped me remember the facts various aspects. So it has helped me in remembering them easily. Second, when it comes to the mock tests, previously I was going around the mock tests of various institutes, but never got the time to revise them. So this time I have limited them as well. I have sticked to one or two test series and revised them multiple times again. And this attempt, I have focused. In the past three attempts, I didn't have a strategy on how to go about for those 2 hours in prelims, which matters the most. So this time I had come up with a clear strategy on which questions to attempt first. Which there are three kind of questions in prelims generally that are being asked. So which kind of questions to be attempted first, and how many rounds that I would go through the entire paper, and also how many number of questions I would attempt. So this kind of clear-cut strategy has helped me this time in prelims. And finally, though those 2 hours matter the most, and how mentally stable, mentally calm you are and composed you are decides your destiny. So for that, I had been focusing on my mental strength as well. I had been meditating every day for 15-20 minutes so that I have a calm and composed mind. Then being a cricketer, previously I had been working out, like I had been indulging in a physical workout or a sport for 30 minutes every day at least, and proper diet and minimum 8 hours of sleep. So all this had taken care of those 2 hours as well, and I could focus more in those 2 hours. So all this, I think, have helped me clear the prelims this time.
Okay. So as you said that you are a cricketer, so maybe you know, means I mean, what type of cricketer, means do you play any district level, something like that?
I have been a cricketer since my childhood. I have represented the under-19 state cricket team for the Hyderabad team, and also represented the university team for all the 4 years in my graduation, and also was the captain of the university team in the final year. So. Okay. I was more professionally into cricket prior to starting my civil services preparation.
Okay. And then regarding prelims, you said that you wrote less number of test series, but you revised them more frequently so that you got the confidence. One common question in the minds of most of the students is generally, if you take current affairs and static part, what should you focus mostly on for the prelims? Means how the time division should be?
I would like to slightly clarify here. I would suggest it is advisable that having an integrated approach for both the static as well as the current FAS aspects in the entire preparation, not just for prelims but also for the mains as well. The approach that I followed was once I had done with the static part, the NCRTs, I had gone through the NCRTs first, then went to the standard books. Once a thorough reading has been done, then I moved to the current affairs. So while reading the current affairs as well, say for instance, if there is any update on anti-defection law, for instance, so I would go back to the this standard book like Lakshmikant and read about that anti-defection law from the standard book as well, so that an integrated approach was always there, and that helped in my prelims where I could answer the analytical type of questions, and also in my mains where in answer writing I could quote the relevant articles or the judgments in my answers. So this integrated approach is very necessary in the entire preparation.
Okay. So you combine them both with pairing.
Yes.
One other common doubt is most students who even could not clear the prelims exam or the civils exam for 5 to 6 years, what they feel is, see, everybody reads the same Lakshmikant for polity, NCRTs for geography, history, spectrum for history, or any one current affairs magazine, and for environment there is Shankar book. So everybody reads the same books. So as a ranker, I mean, the doubt in the minds of general aspirants is, do you read anything beyond that? Do you read any more books, or within these books are you able to get the success?
What I would suggest is keeping the sources limited, as I already said. Keeping the same kind of books that you have been reading over the years, that would suffice for this preparation. But at the same time, focusing on solving questions and also I missed a point previously, focus on previous year questions as well. By solving the previous year questions, you would get to know what kind of questions that UPSC is asking. You get accustomed to the thinking of UPSC, so which areas it is focusing upon. So I think reading the same books but solving more tests and revising them multiple times, but keep it limited to one or two test series, not more than that, and also the previous year questions. So I think all this would take care of clearing prelims.
Okay. And what are the sources that you depended on when it comes to the current affairs? For prelims as well as mains, current affairs.
Yes. Current affairs, I used to follow a monthly magazine. For instance, the Vision IAS monthly current affairs I used to go through. Also for prelims, if there are any few aspects which are not covered in the monthly current affairs, then I used to take up the PT365 of Vision IAS. And also for mains, the mains 365. So these are the monthly magazines and the institute books. Secondly, I used to follow the newspaper. Newspaper reading was I used to do it regularly, never missed even a day. So that used to broaden my horizon. I mean, give me more perspectives instead of single-minded approach or narrow approach. It used to broaden my horizon. This has helped me in my mains as well as my interviews. Thirdly, I used to follow a daily news analysis video of Rao's IAS, so that if there is something that I didn't understand in the newspaper, then this analysis video would make it easy for me. And also there is one platform called the Study IQ, which I used to follow if at all I don't understand any concept or any news updates. So all these sources I have been following regularly. And finally, for my interview preparation, I had followed the Rajya Sabha TV debates.
Okay. And then how many questions did you attempt in the prelims examination? As there are, you know, wide variety of theories. Some say you attempt only 70 to 75. Some say you should go for 95 questions. You have to guess the questions. So which strategy did you follow?
I was clear in my mind that I had to attempt 80 questions, but this can vary for people to people, because it depends on the accuracy. But I had followed this strategy that I should attempt 80 questions minimum, and if it can go upwards based on the paper.
Okay. And then how many months before the prelims do you suggest to completely stop preparing for mains and just focus on prelims?
For me, prelims has been the most toughest part all these years. So I think I would suggest 2 months before the prelims examination, focus more on solving the questions and the previous year questions and revising whatever you have read multiple number of times.
Okay. So as we have elaborately shared ideas from prelims, let us go to the mains. What was your optional in the mains?
My optional is sociology.
And is there any reason why you have gone for sociology? Do you have any background, something like that?
Nothing. My background is completely different. I come from a computer science engineering background. But the reason for me to choose sociology was I always had interest in the various facets of the society, like learning about the gender equality, how to bring about gender equality. And sociology also deals with certain relevant aspects like the caste system, religion, family, kinship. So I think I've had interest in this subject, and that has driven me towards taking this subject.
Okay. Can you suggest broadly some two or three books which you have followed sociology, which you think is important for sociology aspirants?
First thing, any sociology aspirant needs to study the NCERTs of class 11 and class 12, like Understanding Society and two more other sociology NCERTs. After that, I had read the Hurlumbus sociology book, the orange one, the small one. So even that I hadn't read page by page. I had picked up few topics which I felt I was not comfortable with. So I had taken up such topics like social stratification, power and society, all these topics. And thirdly, when it comes to the books, then Essential Sociology by Nitin Sangwan sir, that also is very helpful, especially for paper 2. These books were supplemented, whatever class notes that I've had were the base for my entire preparation, and these books had only supplemented my class notes.
Okay. So have you made notes from all these books, or you just revised the textbooks again and again?
For sociology, yes, I had made my own notes. This is one advice that I've got from the toppers who have cleared, that never rely on someone else's notes. They were like, make your own notes, so that would help you throughout this preparation. That would help you remember and recollect better in the examination. So I had taken up the syllabus. For every topic in the syllabus, I had made my own notes, 2-3 pages notes in my own handwriting, and that has helped.
And have you written any mock exams, mock tests for the optional?
Yes. I had joined Shankar Iyer's sociology test series, and also Vikas Ranjan sir's test series for sociology. But I was not able to give all the tests, but around 10 to 12 tests I had given, totally, from both the institutes.
Okay. And then they say that in general studies, generally, the difference between the mocks of a topper and the ranks of top 200 and the below ranks may not be huge, but the difference in the ethics and essay and optional are generally very high. So in this aspect, for essay, do you what strategy have followed? What worked out for you in essay writing?
Essay, first thing that needs to be kept in mind for essay is that your general studies and your optional knowledge, you should be thorough in that. So that will broaden your thinking when it comes to essay writing. So I had followed that approach. Secondly, I had delineated the topics based on the previous year questions in essay. I had come up with a broad topics of like 10 to 15 topics, like for instance, science and technology, women empowerment, agriculture, such topics. I had, for every topic, I had collected the relevant quotes, relevant facts, and could come up with certain anecdotes which I felt I could use in the in my essay. Then third part of the approach is writing essays continuously. This I had done after my prelims. Every week I used to write one or two essays, so and get them corrected so that I was more confident in that aspect. I mean, coming up with a proper introduction, then the body, and then conclusion. So for all this, I think practice is something which is very essential.
Okay, okay. Then after the essay, as you start writing GS 1, 2, 3 and 4, time management is the biggest problem. And we see that even the top rankers mostly may not be able to finish the papers. Some people say that you have to finish the paper though quality is less, where some say quality can be compromised to finish the paper. So regarding this quality and quantity debate, where do you stand in the mains, GS 1, 2, 3 or 4?
There needs to be a balance. What I feel is there needs to be a balance. I mean, your quality, in the race to complete the 20 answers, quality should never be neglected is what I feel. So for this, the approach that I followed is I used to write answers every day, one or two answers every day for GS, or one answer for my optional. So then I used to focus more on quality. So once I felt that my quality aspect is fine, then after I cleared prelims, then I focused on improving my speed. I still remember even 2 months before my mains, I was not able to complete the entire paper when I had given a GS test or the optional test. But timing the answer writing, for instance, 10 marker answer, I tried completing in 6 or 7 minutes, 6 minutes to be precise, more precise. And the 15 markers answer in 11 minutes. So this has helped me. This timing of the answer writing has helped me write all the answers in my mains examination. I haven't missed even one answer in any of the papers. So I think first my focus was on quality, then I moved towards the quantity.
Okay, okay. So finally, you're able to attend for all 1,000 mocks, GS 1, 2, 3, 4. You're able to finish all the papers finally.
Yes. Okay. Even in my optional.
Okay. And particularly regarding GS2, General Studies 2, GS1 and 3, most students write in the point format. When it comes to GS2, they'll be confused of whether to write in paragraphs, because if you have to analyze every question of quality, it will become lengthy, long, and you cannot generate more points. So how did you write that? More paragraphs or points, short answers? What is your strategy, GS2?
For all the three papers of general studies, GS 1, 2, 3, I had followed only one approach to write the answers in points. I only had written an introduction of three to four lines and the conclusion of two to three lines. That's all that in paragraph. Other than that, the entire body part was in points. Because for an examiner to correct an answer sheet, he or she might get 5 to 10 minutes if I'm not wrong. So there would be very less time. So putting my points, whatever I think in concise way, I mean in with subheadings and in points format, I think would make it easy for the examiner as well. So I think for GS 1, 2, 3, I had followed the points approach.
And when it comes to flowcharts, diagrams or maps, are you a person who use a lot of these things, or you just write the answer and not go for more diagrams and flowcharts?
Limited. I mean, anything needs to be done in a more balanced way. So if there is a necessity of a diagram to be drawn in the answer, then I would definitely draw. And I used to keep one flow chart per one answer, not more than that. My suggestion is do not overdo the use of flow charts or diagrams. Keep them balanced. One diagram or one flow chart in an answer would make the answer look more unique and make it easy for the examiner as well.
Okay. And when it comes to ethics, for ethics, some students use lot of thinkers, theories, quotations. Whereas some say, you know, you have to write your own ideas and no need to really bring in thinkers and theories. Or what books have you studied? Broadly, your strategy or approach towards ethics, what is your suggestion?
My approach for ethics was that I followed, I had read Lexicon ethics book prior to this attempt. But for this attempt, I had read D.K. Balaji ethics book. So, and I had come up with a list of some 70 to 80 keywords in ethics, like integrity, honesty, these kind of keywords. And for every keyword, I used to write definition in my own words, because otherwise what happens is everyone comes up with a similar kind of definition. They copy paste from the book. So I think that is a slightly wrong approach. So I used to write the definition in my own words. And for every term, I used to come up with a standard example from some great personalities like Mahatma Gandhi, APJ Abdul Kalam. And another example from my own life, my own experiences. So this used to make my answer look a little unique. So this takes care of the Section A part in ethics. So Section B is all about case studies. So for case studies, I used to take a holistic approach. Like for instance, even if the stakeholders are not asked in the exam, I used to mention them somewhere in my answer. And the way forward or the course of action to be followed, I took a long-term, short-term approach. So all this used to make my case study answer holistic. So for case studies, I think rigorous practice is what is necessary and helps to complete all the case studies within time. So this is broadly my strategy for ethics paper.
Okay. So here, as you said, rigorous practice for case studies. So may I know how many mock tests, for general studies overall, how many tests you would have written before going to the mains actually?
For general studies as a whole, as I said previously, as I used to write answers every day, so my quality aspect was taken care of. But I had written mock tests like for GS 1, 2, 3, two papers each, not more than that, because I only had to improve my speed. So I had given limited tests for GS, and for GS4 specifically, I had given like 3-4 mock tests, 3 to 4.
Okay. So you have done more essay tests than general studies mock tests, in fact, because as you said, you wrote essay almost every week.
Yes. So I never used to write it in a within a specific time as such, but every week I used to write one essay. Even though it took more time initially, but later I could complete an essay within 1.5 hour.
Okay. And then as we have covered the mains part, let's come to the final part of the CIVS examination, the interview, the personality test. So in personality test, what are the areas you are broadly tested in your interview?
Personality test, as the name itself says, it's all about how one's personality is, like how an individual copes with the stress, or how honest he is to his abilities or to his values, and whether he is bluffing or something like that. All these aspects will be scrutinized in the interview. Apart from the knowledge aspect. So I think for this, I had started looking more towards myself. I had started collecting my own experiences, reflecting upon them since my childhood, what all I have gone through in my life. So that has given a fair understanding of what is my personality about. And secondly, I used to sit in front of a mirror for almost the entire preparation of my interview. And whatever I used to speak, I used to see look at myself in the mirror. So that gave me a fair idea of how my expressions are, and well, if I pose a question to myself, whether I am answering it correctly, whether I am satisfied with the answer. So it has given me given a fair understanding of how I answer. Then thirdly, for me, it was my sister. I used to sit with my sister, and she used to ask me questions from the transcripts of the candidates who have already completed their interviews. So since she knows me right from my childhood, she was able to correct wherever I go wrong. I mean, if I'm taking stress or something like that, she was able to correct me. But for any other aspirant, it can be anyone, not just the siblings. It can be any friend who has known him or her from childhood, or who has observed that person closely. And finally, when it comes to mock interviews, I had given one or two mock interviews, that's all, because I thought I should be more natural in my approach, more original when I answer. So this is a basic strategy that I followed for interview.
Okay. As you have already got a very good rank of 103, mostly you don't need to write the exam. But if, let us say, you want to write the exam once again, let us say you have got a lower rank and you want to write once again, what things you would change for the next attempt? Anything that you would change?
That is what I have. I mean, if at all I get IPS this time, maybe I would think of writing again. But I have been eagerly waiting for the mark sheet to be out so that I can do the self-analysis and work on areas that I have I might have gone wrong, because as of now I have no idea where I could have gone wrong.
Okay. And then, you know, the important question which generally most of the students who fail this examination repeatedly, what they wanted is, number one, what actually kept you motivated? How could you keep your motivation to finally reach this such a good rank, 103?
Yes. Firstly, my family support has been immense in this. Whenever I felt low, I used to talk to my sister, my parents. They used to boost me so that I can double up my efforts and identify my weaknesses and work upon them. Secondly, I used to follow a lot of bureaucrats already in service, or the ex-bureaucrats. Their work used to inspire me. Like, for instance, Anil Swarup sir, the ex-school secretary and education secretary, I used to read his books. And Mahesh Bhagwat sir, for instance, his work, I mean, he is an IPS officer, his work used to inspire me. So I used to follow them online. And apart from that, the zeal, the determination to be a change maker in the society. I mean, to contribute to the nation building process and be part of the decision making and policy making thing. I think all this all these factors used to motivate me throughout my preparation.
Okay. And then we have many people who came to interview but who could not clear this year. And as they would be seeing your interview, if you want to tell them something for the students who failed this year, if you want to tell them something, can you just tell a few things for them as they have prelims just 2 months away?
So first things first, never lose hope for all the aspirants who could not get through this time. Never lose hope, because until and unless you put your 100% effort and it is just a matter of time. I think if you identify your weaknesses and where you have gone wrong and improve upon that, I think it is just a matter of time for you to clear this exam. Secondly, I think now the prelims is fast approaching. So focus more on that, more on prelims. Focus on solving questions and the previous year questions, as I've already said. And keep your sources limited and revise them multiple times. So I think all these changes, do a self-analysis of yourself, where you have gone wrong and all that. I think with this and increasing your efforts, I think success will be yours.
Thank you for sharing your ideas and for spending this much time. I hope the students who are starting off this year, or even the students who missed this year at next year, after seeing your interview, they'll have a lot of take-home points, as you are given many insights, crucial insights, at all stages of prelims mains interview. Thank you once again, and we congratulate you once again for your success.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure talking to you and all the aspirants who are watching this interview. Thank you.